Honor 9X Pro has been out in China since last year, and it's finally coming to the UK and Europe, with one big caveat: no Google. Hi, I'm Hannah, and I'm from Tech Advisor, and today we're getting a first glimpse at the 9X Pro from Honor, the follow-up to the 9X, which came out in the UK in autumn last year. Now, this phone is taking a lot of things from the base model that we really enjoyed, as well as several upgrades. But before we get onto those, let's talk about the elephant in the room. So Honor is a sub-brand of Huawei, and therefore it was hit by the US trade ban. Now, if you'd like to know a little bit more about that, you can click on the link below. This means, though, that the phone will come without Google services. So it'll come without Google Drive, Gmail, Google Docs, YouTube. Basically, if you enjoy Google and want it in the phone out of the box, you're not going to get it on this phone. Now, there are ways around this, of course. We've managed to sideload Google Apps on the Huawei Mate 30 Pro, but this does require some work. If, however, Google really isn't your bag, or you're interested in the Huawei / Honor ecosystems, then maybe this is a different story for you. This is also especially true if you're thinking about investing in another product from one of these brands, like a laptop. So let's look at the design of the phone. So from the exterior, we can see that it's actually got quite a nice design. It comes in either a black variant or this pink and purple ombre effect that we had a look at. You get this really nice unique X3D design on the back, which is quite unique in comparison to a lot of other mid-range rivals. In addition to that, the actual material of the phone is made of glass, which is a big upgrade from the plastic that the 9X had. So the phone comes with 6GB RAM and 250GB worth of storage. Also comes with a Kirin 810 processor, which is a big upgrade from the last one. And in theory, this should make the phone perform a lot faster and perhaps have upgrades to mobile gaming and allegedly the night mode on the camera. Speaking of cameras, the Honor 9X Pro comes with a triple camera with a 48MP main lens, a wide lens, and a depth lens. On the front, you also get a motorized pop-up selfie camera, which is 16MP. And that provides a bezel-less display and also just gives an overall full view look at the phone. The Honor 9X Pro also comes with Android 9, which is run on Huawei's EMUI 9.1 skin. So that's like a decent mid-range OS for this type of phone. It's obviously not the latest, which would be Android 10, but that's to be expected on this type of phone. Underneath the hood, you also get a 4000 mAh battery. So this is the same battery that was actually on the Honor 9X, and I found it to be pretty good, lasting about a day and a half's worth of usage, looking at videos, social media, that sort of thing. You also get USB-C charging, a headphone jack, and a microSD slot in case you want any extra storage. So our final thoughts about the Honor 9X Pro. When it comes to design, this is quite a nice upgrade, especially the color that we've got on there. And also it'd be interesting to see how that processor actually works out when it comes to everyday performance. But, and it's a big but, having no Google is really going to be a deal breaker for some people. The fact is that if you've got nothing there on the phone already, you just may not want to be invested in it. And we're still not sure how the Huawei Honor ecosystem is going to go down in Europe. It may have been a storm in China, but we're not sure if it's the same yet. Only time will really tell. What do you think of the Honor 9X Pro and the omission of Google? Let us know in the comments below and subscribe for more tech reviews on our channel. You can also tune in to our weekly phone show Fast Charge, which airs every Thursday. Thank you very much. Bye.